ladies and gentlemen, this contest, our final event, it is for the Intercontinental Championship, and it is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first the manager, the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. He represents the challenger from Seattle, Washington, weighing 249 pounds, Greg the Hammer Valentine. And his opponent, weighing 275 pounds, here is the Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior.
Boy, what a collision this is going to be between the Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior, and Greg the Hammer Valentine. As you see, Alfred Valentine not moving in the center of the ring, but there's a lot of motion on the outside.
There is. If ever a man comes into the ring fired up, nobody does it more so than this man, the Ultimate Warrior, the Intercontinental Champion. And look at Valentine, he's standing there, but he better watch, he better keep a very, very close eye on that man who's moving like a freight train across the ring.
The Hammer, Greg Valentine, still not moving at all, but there you see the Warrior going across. Well, Valentine should have watched himself that time, but he ducked down. The Warrior goes outside, and now going after the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart.
Well, I do believe Hart was on the outside giving him some sort of vocal grief there, but look at that. Has worked. But then again, of course, I didn't take into consideration the tremendous strength and power that the Warrior obviously possesses.
And he's really fired up for this one. Look at him. Well, on the back, Jimmy Hart. I don't know what he's doing there, and I'm sure he feels the same way right now. The Warrior sends him and rolls in after him, and the Warriors had to contend with two men here. Watch out from behind. The Hammer using the heartbreaker shin guard on the back of the Ultimate Warrior.
And that's exactly what he did. And unfortunately for the Warrior, that time he did get caught. He was taken in by the ruse that was employed by Jimmy Hart and Greg Valentine. He's rapidly trying to get the heartbreaker back in. I think he's going to go for his submission hold.
Maybe so. Try to take the man down quickly. And there's an elbow to the back of the neck. We are at the Bradley Center here in Milwaukee. A gigantic crowd on hand as the Ultimate Warrior and Greg Valentine do battle. And Valentine on the offense right now.
And look at the way he kicked to the midriff of the Ultimate Warrior while he was wearing that heartbreaker, that device, that infernal thing he has strapped around his left shin. But look at Warrior, he comes back so strongly. This man is absolutely made of steel.
Head first, Valentine goes to the top turnbuckle, and the Warrior picks him up. Makes it look so easy, doesn't
he? He really does. Just tremendous power there. A little bit slow by the Warrior, though, in fact. And Valentine, he did take a big, powerful slam, but he was equal to the task, and he got away from that other move that was made and executed by the Warrior.
Warrior kicks out. Valentine goes right to the offense again. Right hands. These are forearms. And he slips them in, sending the Warrior back. Snapmares him out. Valentine taking his time outside, now climbing the turnbuckle.
And he really is taking a lot of time there. He's poised on that middle rope. He's obviously waiting for the Warrior to get to his feet. Oh, nicely judged by Valentine. Really a great move by Greg Valentine.
Nice handle blow right to the back of the neck. But look at the Warrior. He's coming right back, sending Valentine down face first.
Well, fortunately for Valentine, he was able to shield his head from that tremendous blow with his left forearm. But he's still staggering. He's still stunned by the Warrior. In fact, I do believe both men are stunned, but the Warrior is showing signs of a quicker recovery.
The Warrior coming back again, as we've seen him do so many times. Big roundhouse and a clothesline out of the corner. And the fans respond to that. He may look to press slam the Hammer, Greg Valentine.
And look at this, the Warrior moving very, very well again, and he's picked back that speed. Obviously, both men were showing the signs of wear a little while ago, but now it's Valentine, the Hammer, who is showing more signs of wear. Look at this! Hung in behind! Oh, he got caught!
He was going to hit him with that shin guard, but as the Warrior turned around, he strapped the shin guard onto the mat. The Warrior, now with his attention to the Mouth of the South, picks the manager up, throws him to Greg Valentine, and both men go down. Valentine gets up again. The Warrior has the shin guard and a big clothesline. And now the count. And that's it. So Jimmy Hart can only fault himself.
And still, Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Ultimate Warrior.
It appears they were bent on trying to destroy this man with that shin guard, but it didn't work.
No, it absolutely backfired upon them, and the Warrior came out a magnificent victor there. Let us see exactly how this happened. Jimmy Hart found himself, unfortunately for him, in the ring. I don't know whether he did this on purpose. I believe he did, because he was trying to get the Warrior's attention diverted. It didn't work. And now look, watch closely. The Warrior picks up that heartbreaker. He puts it on his right arm and comes in with his tremendous clothesline. And down goes the hammer, and a successful title defense once again by the Warrior. What a magnificent champion he is.
There's no doubt about that. Pretty good try by Greg the Hammer Valentine. He wanted to be the Intercontinental Champion. But to do so, you got to get through this man. He is the Ultimate Warrior, and he is awesome.